Bonjour à tous. Very pleased to be with you today to talk about a common creative passion that behavioral science and French have in common for urine. I lead the behavioral science practice of Ogilvy Consulting in Paris, and as my colleagues across the world, we are fighting for a truly creative application of behavioral science. So it felt natural for us to attack the challenge of public urination. Think of the flies of Schiphol Airport urinals, probably the most famous nudge in the world and probably the most creative one too. Think of the brilliant intervention that Indians came up with to fight against public urination, sticking ceramic tiles of gods on walls. Who would dare to pee on their gods? No one, of course. Now about the French. Who would dare to put his signature on a urinal and declare it's a piece of art? Marcel Duchamp did it, and his masterpiece is considered as one of the most influential work in the history of modern art. More generally, French love their freedom to pee in the street. Best client you can think of came to see us, SNCF, French National Rail. There are so many spots to hide from the crowd and have a discreet pee. Station walls are among men's favorite spots to urinate. Corners, platform ends, stairs, but there is more. SNCF is also a pioneer in behavioral sciences. They have created a nudge unit more than 4 years ago, and they feel they are ready to tackle the public urination issue. 35 minutes northwest of Paris, the Gare des Mureaux is considered as a particularly problematic station, especially one wall outside of the station. Men pee next to the entrance station workers use when arriving in the morning. It creates unhappy workers, unhappy clients, and you can imagine the impact on the image of SNCF. The nudge unit wants to use Le Gare des Mureaux as a pilot to test an intervention that they could massify to all the other stations in France. They know it's a tough one. They have tried everything: signage, posters, fines, organic urinals. When you pee, you make plants grow. Splashback paint. After 1 day, 1 week, 1 month, men start again to pee on the walls. None of it worked. They also know we have to cope with the broken window theory. Remember Philippe Zimbardo, a famous psychologist of Stanford? That means the rule of the game is very clear. We have to kill public urination, no mercy. Because if we know that one man continues to pee on the wall, the corner will start to stink again, and then the general public will avoid the corner, and it will make the corner even more discreet, and we will be back to where we started. First, we build a team. Experts from the nudge unit of the SNCF, people from the station itself, our teams composed of behavioral strategists and creatives. Plus, we love to be accompanied by an academic expert. In that case, it was Nicolas Fiolin, associate professor of psychology at the University of Lyon. And Nicolas has a great experience already working with the nudge unit. So we start by reading the literature. We observe, we wander about, we discuss with people. And we realize that peeing in the streets in Les Mureaux is socially accepted. Ask to anyone in the street, you want to pee, they will indicate you many places where you can pee. Behind the bushes, stairs, behind the buildings, and of course the walls of the station. Situation seems bad, very bad. So we need to reframe. We need to make it absolutely clear that this place is not a place where you can pee. We need to give a new function to the space. A function that will be, again, crystal clear, obvious. No, these walls are not a place where you can pee. In 4 years' time, Paris will host the Olympic Games. So we will create a mini running track for kids with a timer so that they can beat their records, and with a public, an audience, so that they can really think that they are running in the Stade de France. And when the kids are not around, you still have the public watching you straight into the eyes, or rather under the belly. Believe me, it's a strange feeling when you want to have a discreet pee. Scientific literature depicts a similar case in Montreal. Junkies had made Berry Square their favorite square in town. They changed the name to Parc Émilie Gamelin. They planted some trees, they added some giant chessboards, and families took back control of the square. No more junkies. In fact, what we do here is bring back social norms, social control. We remember to everyone that you don't pee in front of children. You don't pee on a children's playground. So we decided to add a third layer of psychological creativity. When you are a man and you have an urgent need to urinate, you are irresistibly attracted by corners. It's not by chance if, in French, toilets are called petits coins, little corners. So would there be a way to erase corners? Of course there is a way. We will use lots of circles, round shapes, anamorphic design to create optical illusions. And at the end of the days, the corners will seem erased. Now, we feel really confident, and so does SNCF. It's time to prototype and to test. Prototyping is rather easy, except that we don't have a lot of money, and SNCF loves so much the idea that if it is successful, they would like the intervention to stay for 3 or 4 years. It's not anymore what we call a prototype, but this is the brief. Measuring was a bit more complicated. We wanted to know exactly the number of acts of urination. So we had to invent our own solution, our urine detector. The combination of a humidity sensor will record the presence of liquid on the wall, and of a temperature sensor who will differentiate rain from urine. We conducted a before-after experiment in 2019. 4 weeks of control, 4 weeks for test. And now, the results. During the control period, 147 acts of urination are recorded in total. 44 outside, 103 inside. During the test period, 17 acts of urination are recorded. Not a single act outside, 17 acts recorded inside. A total reduction of 88%. Big success. It's been almost 1 year since the intervention happened. The intervention shows signs of wear. Crack, dirt, tags, but not one single stain of urine, not one single smell. We never knew how well the Schiphol flies did. Most favorable result is said that it reduced urine spillage by 80%. We did better, 88%. More important, we are continuing to work with SNCF to deploy the intervention in another 8 to 10 stations. We want to cover all kinds of situations so that we can create a playbook, so that we can massify the intervention in all stations in France. Last, if I add one thing that I'd like you to remember today, it's the importance of creativity. Creativity augments the power of behavioral science significantly. Thank you very much.